Wolfenstein, Impede, and Stabler. In the previous video, we have studied two tabled sections, exponential tabled section and triangular tabled section, as a tabled section for matching real load impedance to a transmission line of characteristic impedance Z0. And we said that by using small reflection concept, we can obtain a function for the reflection coefficient as a function of L over lambda. And in the case of exponential tabled section, we said that, or we proved that the minimum length to obtain zero reflection coefficient is lambda over 2. And above length lambda over 2, the reflection coefficient has the form of sinc function. On the other hand, for triangular tabled section, the minimum length to obtain zero reflection coefficient is lambda, not lambda 2, as in the case of exponential tabled section. On the other hand, the reflection coefficient after a length greater than lambda is proportional to sinc squared, not sinc function. The question now is, what will be the optimum tabled section distribution which will introduce a zero reflection coefficient at smallest normalized length, or in other words, length over lambda? In addition, it will introduce the minimum or at least constant reflection coefficient at frequencies higher than the frequency which correspond to the minimum lengths. Wolfenstein answered on this question by using tabled section based on multi-section Chebyshev polynomial. If you remember, when we studied multi-section Chebyshev polynomial, we said that the reflection coefficient will have a constant amplitude. So, based on multi-section Chebyshev polynomial and using the length of sections tends to zero, we can obtain the tabled distribution which will correspond to this Chebyshev multi-section matching set. Actually, we are not going to study the proof of this tabled section, but we are going to present the final form for this tabled section. In this case, the logarithm of the characteristic impedance for Wolfenstein taper is given by ln z as a function of the length z equals half ln z naught multiplied by zl, where z naught is the characteristic impedance of the transmission line and zl is the impedance of the load, plus gamma naught over cosine a multiplied by a squared multiplied by function called phi. This function is function of two parameters. The first parameter is 2z over l minus 1, and the second parameter is a. Actually, the parameter a is determined based on the maximum allowable reflection coefficient. So, the reflection coefficient, if we are going to connect the load impedance to the transmission line z0 directly, will introduce reflection coefficient gamma naught. where gamma naught is z naught minus z naught over z naught plus z naught, which can be approximated as half length z naught over z naught, assuming that we have a small reflection. Now, the maximum allowable reflection coefficient gamma m is obtained in the case of Kolfenstein impedance taper as gamma m equals gamma naught over cosine a. From this we can obtain the parameter a. So the parameter a depends on the maximum allowable reflection coefficient and the reflection coefficient from the load to the impedance of the transmission line. Okay? So this is what is a. On the other hand, the function phi, phi as a function of x and a, equals minus phi of minus x and a. This means that the function phi is an odd function in terms of x. And the function phi of x and a is the integration from 0 to x I1 is the modified Bessel function of the argument a multiplied by square root 1 minus y squared over a multiplied by square root 1 minus y squared, and we are going to make the integration over y. And the integration over y is from 0 to x. This means that if I'm going to calculate phi of 2z over l minus 1 and a, the limit of integration would be from 0 to 2 multiplied by z over l minus 1. This assuming that the magnitude of x is less than unity. Okay? And as I mentioned, I1 here is a modified Bessel function of order 1. From the properties of the function phi of x and a, we can prove that phi of 0 and a, if x is 0, is 0. Phi of x and 0, if the value of a is 0, phi of x and a would and 0 would be x over 2. Phi of 1 and a, if x equals 1, it would be cosine a minus 1 over a squared. These are the properties of the function phi. Actually, the function phi, this integration can be obtained numerically. So, we are not going to find out a closed form for this integration. Now, if we have the characteristic impedance of the taper transmission line section following up this relation, which is a Kolfenstein impedance taper, the obtained reflection coefficient gamma as a function of theta would be half the integration from z equals 0 to the length of the taper transmission line e to the power minus 2j beta z multiplied by the first derivative d over dz ln the characteristic impedance z as a function of z over z naught. And this integration is developed over z. This actually the general relation for any taper section. By applying the logarithm of the characteristic impedance of Kolfenstein impedance taper, which we have already obtained from this relation, and developing this integration, we can find out the corresponding reflection coefficient would be gamma naught multiplied by e to the power minus j beta l cosine square root beta l squared minus a squared over cosine a, where beta l is greater than a. This means that this square root or the argument of this square root is positive. So the argument of the cosine is real value. If the value of beta l is greater than a, this means that the argument of the square root would be negative. It this means that this square root would be imaginary. So this cosine, it can be replaced by cosine. This means that if beta L is smaller than A, then the cosine square root beta L squared minus A squared would be replaced by cosine A squared minus beta L squared. Right? And as I have said, the pass band is defined as beta L is greater than or equals A. Actually, at beta L equal A exactly, when beta L equals A, this cosine term would be unity. Cosine 0 is unity. Okay? So, the amplitude of the reflection coefficient when beta L equals A would be gamma naught over cosine A. And we have already said that gamma naught over cosine A is the magnitude of the maximum allowable reflection coefficient. So, at beta L equals A, starting from beta L equals A, the reflection coefficient is less than or equals the maximum allowable reflection coefficient. And when beta L is going to be greater than A, the value of gamma oscillates between the value of gamma naught and gamma A. So, plus or minus gamma naught over cosine A. It means that the maximum allowable or the maximum reflection coefficient would be gamma M. And the minimum it would be 0. Alright? So, gamma theta oscillates between plus or minus gamma naught over cosine A for beta L greater than A. This briefly what is mean by Klopfenstein impedance state. In the following video, we are going to present an example for the different table section, and we are going to compare between them from where is the minimum reflection coefficient or the first minimum reflection coefficient, and what is the rate of decaying of the reflection coefficient as beta L is going to be greater than the initial value of the minimum reflection coefficient. Okay, see you in the next video for the example on the different table sections.